Hello everyone, we already know the process by which a changing magnetic field in a conductor induces a current in it is called electromagnetic induction. And the induced current is found to be the highest when the direction of motion of the coil is at right angles to the direction of magnetic field. In such situation, we use Fleming's right-hand rule to know the direction of induced current. Now, this principle of electromagnetic induction is also employed to produce large currents for use in homes and industries. And this device is called electric generator. So remember, an electric generator works on the principle of electromagnetic induction, and electricity is generated by rotating a coil in the magnetic field. Thus, in an electric generator, mechanical energy is used to rotate the coil and mechanical energy gets converted to electrical energy. So let us see the working of a simple electric generator. But first, let us understand a simple model of an electric generator. An electric generator consists of a rotating rectangular coil, which we have represented by coil ABCD here, and this is placed between the two poles of a permanent magnet. And here again, the placement is such that the coil is perpendicular to the magnetic field. Now, the two ends of this coil, that is coil ABCD, are connected to the two separate rings, which are represented by R1 and R2 here. You know, the inner sides of these rings are made insulated, and these two rings, R1 and R2, are internally attached to an axle. And how is motion created? The axle may be mechanically rotated from outside to rotate the coil inside the magnetic field to create motion. Now, to create a path for induced current, the two rings, that is R1 and R2, are in contact with two separate brushes, which we represent here by B1 and B2. You know, these two conducting stationary brushes, B1 and B2, are kept pressed separately on R1 and R2 respectively. Now, how to verify the presence of induced current? Well, the outer ends of the two brushes are connected to the galvanometer to show the flow of current in the given external circuit. So to reiterate, what are the important components of an electric generator? Well, it consists of a rectangular coil which needs to be rotated in a magnetic field. So we have a permanent magnet, and for rotation of the coil, it is connected to two separate rings, R1 and R2, and these two separate rings are connected to an axle. Also, to provide a path for induced current, the two rings, that is R1 and R2, are in contact with two separate conducting brushes, which are B1 and B2 respectively. So now that you know the main components of an electric generator, we shall learn about the working of an electric generator in the next class. Until then, bye-bye.